Everyone, and welcome to my Why Python 3 video. This video is also going to serve as the first video in my Python 3 programming tutorial series, though there will be nothing more than just information on Python 3 versus Python 2 in this video, and why you should choose Python 3. Video 2 will begin with the downloading and installation of Python 3. Also, I'm going to mention here, and again later on in the series, that the series is going to be geared towards the complete noob for Python. So if you're used to Python 2.7 already, making the transition to Python 3 is really not that difficult. I will probably make a Py2 to Py3 transitional video after I finish this series, but that's probably a little bit away. So on with the video. Why Python 3? So throughout my time with Python programming, I've visited and revisited the idea of Python 3 countless times. When I first started, that's exactly what I did, and I've always come up with the exact same answer every time. Python 3, on the whole, is not better than Python 2, yet it has less support, documentation, and libraries. Basically, all of the good things in Python 3, for the most part, not all of them, but a lot of them, have actually been ported backwards into Python 2. More on why that must be really frustrating later. But anyways, a few months ago, I watched a YouTube video of a presentation about why one should choose Python 3. It was something like, why Python 3, trust me, it's better. Something like that, right? And it was given by an actual developer for Python 3. Through the entire presentation, now given it's probably just the case that because I'm not an expert or a professional, I guess professional is a bad word. I am a professional, but I'm not an expert. Through the entire presentation, I was still left not really seeing any reason based on that presentation and what was said in that presentation. I saw no reason to switch, right? But instead, I could really sense like the frustration in this guy's voice, right? The lack of adoption for Python 3 is actually an interesting topic of discussion, right? The story of Python 3 could make like a nerdy Greek tragedy movie or something, seriously. Now, this stuff said, you know, I'm not suggesting people move to Python 3 out of pity. That's not a very valid reason or a good idea at all. But there are some good reasons why you should move to Python 3. See, Python 3 is really the future. Python 2 is not. If you stick with Python 2 and Python 2 only, and everybody does this, you're going to be able to get away with it for a while, and then you'll find yourself using Python 2 in a time where it's comparable to using something like Pascal today, right? At the same time, Python itself will probably fall behind as a developmental language or a programming language just simply due to the lack of support and community overall. Python, in my honest opinion, is simply the best language out there. It's very high level, and yet it has incredible power, and due to its high level nature, it's also very simplistic. It's just a great language, and it would be a shame to really see it become outdated just simply because the community was disinterested in moving forward with the language. And I really can't imagine how annoying it must be for the Py3 developers, you know, that people just simply aren't adopting the new language for not too great of reasoning, in my opinion. So in the end, the deciding factor for me to not adopt Python 3 was the lack of documentation and support, right? It was when I was a noob to programming in Python, and I really needed that support, just as anybody new to any language needs some sort of, you need the community and the support in order to progress in that language, right? And I looked at both languages, and to me, they seemed equal, right? Equal, but the community surrounding them was very different in size. So it seemed to make sense for me as a noob to go with Python 2.7. And I believe that's that was a very logical choice. And so anybody else that's doing the same thing, I completely sympathize with why that is the choice at the moment. Now that I'm someone that, you know, has had this channel and I'm making all these videos on YouTube, I seem to be doing something right enough to where at least a decent amount of people enjoy how I teach. And I think it's almost somewhat of my responsibility to share and teach Python 3 at this point. This way, maybe in the future when, you know, someone does a search for Python 3 versus Python 2.7, maybe they'll find my video, or maybe they'll find stuff from people that I helped get started, or you know, whatever, in Python 3 can actually start to grow, you know? Because for the most part right now, when you hear a Python 3 versus Python 2 discussion, the differences are really only geared towards, I would say, the expert or at least professional Python developer, but I would argue most professional Python developers couldn't care less about these tiny differences. And then the main question of performance is Py 3 or Py 2 faster? They are pretty much equal all the way down. So there was in that in the video from the guy, trust me, Py 3 is better, or I forget the title, but in that video he does compare, you know, the performance, and depending on the task, sometimes Py 2 is faster, sometimes Py 3 is faster. The differences are so minute that performance isn't the issue. So it really comes down to a few just tiny differences that at the moment are so tiny that it just doesn't make sense. But in the future, if Python 3 is allowed to continue growth and development, Python 3 will be the victor. But if obviously no one supports it, then that sort of stuff is never going to happen, and you won't have modules and all this kind of stuff. So, back to, you know, a video like this guy, though, you know, by this time, you know, that video is kind of geared towards at least, you know, most likely an expert. And by that time that, you know, Py 3 makes sense to the expert, the developer has already gone through their noob stage and probably did the whole Python 2 versus Python 3, decided Py 2 was the best start, and then got ingrained in their ways, right? And then it's very hard to get them to switch. And a lot of people don't see a reason to switch. So here, my goal is to offer a full slew of beginner and partially intermediate Python tutorials, all using Python 3, right? So my Python 2.7 tutorials will remain here. I'm not going to delete them or anything, but I'm going to be doing my best to offer the same topics, only in Python 3. And some modules that are pretty popular in Python 2 still aren't available in Python 3. So we can work on at least probably covering at least one of those modules as far as like how you could port them, because really porting them isn't that big of a deal. Some of them are harder than others, but anyway, this way, hopefully you'll be able to get through that noob and intermediate stage of learning Python, and you'll be able to do it with Python 3. So with that, let's go ahead and start Python 3. As always, everyone, thanks for watching, thanks for all the support of the subscriptions, and until the next video.